Today, in this class, we are discussing the problems on the binomial theorem. As we have already discussed, the theorem of the binomial theorem states that for any x and y are the two real numbers and n is any positive integer, then the statement said that the x plus y whole raised to n is equal to c of n comma 0 x raised to n into y raised to 0 plus c of n comma 1 x raised to n minus 1 into y raised to 1 plus c of n comma 2 x raised to n minus 2 into y square, so on, plus c of n comma r x raised to n minus r into y raised to r, plus so on, c of n comma n x raised to n minus n into y raised to n is the statement of the binomial theorem. So based on this binomial theorem, we have seen all the some important notes. So that is, the number of terms in the expansion will be n plus 1, and the r plus 1, the term will be considered as a general term, that is the c of n comma r x raised to n minus r into y raised to r. And also the number of terms in the expansion is odd, then the middle term will be only one middle term that we have discussed. Suppose if there is a 7 odd numbers, then the middle term will be 7 plus 1 by 2, that is 4. Same as it is if the number of terms in the expansion is even. For example, even number will be taken as a 2, and suppose the 8, then the middle terms are 8 by 2, that is 2n by 2 equal to 4. And also n plus 1th term, that is if 2n equal to 8, n equal to 4. So 4 and n plus 1 equal to 5. Suppose 2n equal to 8, then n equal to 4, n plus 1 equal to 5. 4th and 5th terms are the middle terms of the expansion. So same as it is, we have find out the middle terms for both even and odd numbers. So next, also the coefficient of the terms x raised to n minus r and y raised to r. So that we have to find out the coefficient of the numbers, so that x is selected in n minus r ways, y is selected in a r ways. So with the n variables, with the factors. So the total number of selection will be c of n comma n minus r. So this term is called the binomial coefficient. And also the above can be extended for finding the multinomial coefficient. So what is the meaning of the multinomial coefficient and how to find out the multinomial coefficient? I just simply write the formula here. Exactly how to solve this will be seen particularly with the example. Now I am moving to the example for the all the kinds of the problems on the binomial theorem here. In that, see here, the first example is find the coefficient of a raised to 5 b raised to 2 in the expansion of 2a minus 3b whole raised to 7. 2a minus 3b whole raised to 7. So here I am taking in a formula of x plus y whole raised to n. We just have to compare this expansion with the x plus y whole raised to n. So if you compared it, then your x equal to 2a, y equal to minus 3b, and compare it with the n, x plus y whole raised to n, 2a minus 3b whole raised to 7, then your n equal to 7. Now come to here, find the coefficient of a raised to 5 b raised to 2. Find the coefficient of a raised to 5 b raised to 2. Now compare it with here, coefficient of x raised to n minus r y raised to r. Here you can make either a as a x or else b as a x, whatever you wish. So here I am comparing a as a x, y as a b. So if I compare here, b raised to 2 means r equal to. Also, if you compare it in the reverse way, suppose if we consider this one as a y, then y raised to 5. If you consider the A as a Y, then your R equal to 5. If you consider a B as a X, then you have to find out the N minus R. So you can make it a vice versa also. Here I am taking directly R equal to 2 by comparing the B as a Y, Y raised to R. So your N minus R equal to 5. Now I am moving to the formula. So I am going with the C of n comma n minus r. This term is called the binomial coefficient. So that binomial coefficient will be taken in this manner: C of n comma n minus r into x raised to n minus r into y raised to r. If it is simply x plus y, then we make as usually C of n comma n minus r. But here the coefficient x will be 2a, y equal to minus 3b. Then C of n comma n minus r. The formula will be C of n comma n minus r x raised to n minus r y raised to r. Then the simplification will be C of our n equal to 7, n minus r equal to 5, x equal to 2a raised to 5, y equal to minus 3b whole raised to 2. C of n comma r, n factorial divided by r factorial, n minus r factorial, that is 2 factorial into 2 raised to 5, 32, a raised to 5, minus 3 square is 9 into b square. Simplify the terms here. 7 into 6 divided by 2, 32 into 9 into a raised to 5 b raised to 2. So if you simplify the terms here, you will get 6048 a raised to 5 b raised to 2. Therefore coefficient of a raised to 5 b raised to 2 is a 6048. Like that we have to find out. So whatever the question, if that is in the manner of find the coefficient of the term, then they will give an expansion like this, and they simply mention find the coefficient of some term in the expansion. Comparing the expansion with the x plus y whole raised to n, write down the x, y, n and compare the coefficients as a, if you taken the 2a as a x, then a will be considered as a x raised to n minus r. Suppose if you considered the minus 3b as a y, then the b will be considered as a y. So just we have to be take on the formula of C of n comma n minus r x raised to n minus r into y raised to r. Substitute the n, x and b. So n, x and y, and simplify it, you will get the coefficient of a raised to 5 b raised to 2. So the coefficient will be 6048. So next I am moving to the determine the coefficient of x square y square z cube in the expansion of x plus y plus z whole raised to 7. So this is and come under the example of multinomial coefficients. Multinomial coefficients means suppose the more than of two variables is present in the expansion, that is considered as multinomial coefficient. See here the n equal to 7 and your n1 is here. These are considered as the powers of the coefficients. These are considered as n1, n2, n3. Those will be taken here. N1 equal to 2, N2 equal to 2, N3 equal to 3. If we add all these terms, you must have to obtain the power of the expansion, that is 7. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 3, 7. That should be equal to N that we have in the note. N1 plus N2 plus N3, so on, N t equal to N. And the coefficient is N factorial divided by N1 factorial divided by N2 factorial divided by n3 factorial. So that is equal to 7 factorial, 2 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial. So simplify the factorial terms, we get the 2 10. So here once again I am repeating here, multinomial coefficient means in the expansion more than 2 variables will be present. Those will be equated as x1 plus x2 plus x3 so on whole raised to n. You have to be compare it with the multinomial coefficient as like this, x1 plus x2 plus so on xt whole raised to n. You have to compare it with here. Here only the 3 variables will be there, and the power of n will be here, n equal to 7. And we have to find the coefficient x square, y square, z cube. Here the powers of the x, y, z, if you add these powers, if you add the powers, you must have to obtain the 7. That is the power of the expansion. So the coefficient is given by n factorial, n1 factorial, n2 factorial, n3 factorial is equal to 7 factorial divided by 2 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial. Simplify the terms. 7 into 6 into 5 into 4. 2 into 1, 2 into 1. Simplify it, you will get the 2 10. That is coefficient of x square, y square, z cube. So the one more example here taken on the same topic. See here, determine the coefficient of a square, b cube, c square, d raised to 5. In the expansion of a plus 2b minus 3c plus 2d plus 5 whole raised to 16. Here the expansion a plus 2b minus 3c plus 2d plus 5 whole raised to 16 can be written. We have to consider here u equal to a, v equal to 2b, x equal to minus 2c, y equal to 2d, z equal to 5, and n equal to 16. I am just substituting these values, then it becomes u plus v plus x plus y plus z whole raised to 16. And what we have to be find out? Coefficient of a square, b cube, c square, d raised to 5. Correct? Now, by this comparison, now we have to be find out what? By comparison of this, a is equated to u, then you have to find out the u square, b is equated to v, and that means v cube, c is equated to x, x square, d is equated to y, that is y raised to 5. Now add the terms, 3 plus 2 5, 5 plus 5 10, 10 plus 2 12, but we have to get the 16. So here the coefficients will be equated, so if the powers will be added then it becomes 14. We need a 16, but we have not taken the coefficient for the z, we have to take 4. Because if you add all these, then only we get the 16. We have to make the arrangement for the last term for the z. Now, by the multinomial coefficient, we have to find out the coefficient. So that is taken here, see here. By the multinomial coefficient, n factorial divided by n1 factorial, n2 factorial, n3 factorial, n4 factorial, n5 factorial. Here the n is 16. This is taken as n1, n2, n3, n4, n5. 2 factorial, 3 factorial, 2 factorial, 5 factorial, 4 factorial. That we get 302702400. If you simplify the terms, you will get this value. But this is not exactly the coefficient that we have required. We require the coefficient of a square b cube c square d raised to. This is not actually the required coefficient here, because we need the coefficient of a square b cube c square d raised to 5. Here we find it the coefficient of u square v cube x square y raised to 5 z raised to 4. But here actually u equal to a, v equal to 2b, x equal to minus 3c, y equal to 2d, z equal to 5. We just have to substitute these values of u, v, x, y, z here. So how to get the required term? To get that required term, here we have to take 302702400. So here the coefficient u will be taken as a, write down the a raised to 2. V is taken as 2b, 2b cube. X is taken as minus 3c whole square. Y is taken as 2d whole raised to 5. Z is taken as 5 raised to 4. So that we have to simplify and multiply here. 302702400. So a raised to 2 is a square. 2 cube is 8 into b cube. Minus 3 c square is 9 into c square. 2d raised to 5 means 4 into d raised to 5. 5 raised to 4. So now multiply all these terms. A square, b cube, c square, d raised to 5. Keep as it is and multiply all the terms. Then you will get 4.358914 56 into 10 raised to 14. So that is actually the value that we have obtained if we simplify. So we can compare this example and the previous. In the previous, directly x1, x2, x3 will be given. There is no particularly coefficients for x1, x2, x3. But here the expansion is not directly in the form of x1, x2, x3. Here particularly they have the values a, 2b, minus 3c, 2d and 5. So these coefficients minus 3, 2, 2, 1 and 5 will also have to multiply to the coefficient, and we also have to consider that also in the expansion, so that we have to be get the coefficient 4.358914 56 into 10 raised to 4 is your coefficient of a square b cube c square d raised to 5. So therefore coefficient is, therefore the coefficient is 4.358914 56 into 10 raised to 14. So that is the required coefficient of the expansion.